In this section, we'll take a look at some of the members of the HTML controls. I'll be using the HTML generic control as an example, but the methods and fields are almost the same for all HTML controls. This is because all of them inherit directly from the control class. The only difference between them is the properties relating to the element's specific attributes. And since the generic control doesn't correspond to any special element, it has no such properties. To get started, we'll set the control to represent the div element and add it to the form. The first useful property to know about is inner text, to add text inside an element. A similar field is inner HTML, to add HTML in the element instead of just text. Notice that these two will overwrite each other. Another property that's good to know about is visible, which can be set to false to hide an element. Next, we have the collections. First off, attributes to change the attributes of the element. Similarly, there's the style collection to change the CSS style of the element. And as we've already seen, the controls collection can be used to change the elements inside of this element. Note that since HTML pages are organized as a tree, we can navigate through the child controls using this collection. For example, to get the first child element of the form control, we could access the collection just like an array. There's also the parent property to get the parent of this control.